Hey everyone, in this video we're going to look at the sub-gigahertz transmit and receive frequencies of the Flipper Zero. The video is mostly focused on receiving frequencies and understanding the setting user file that's used to customize the Flipper Zero's sub-gigahertz. I'm located in the US, so please be sure to only do things that are legal in your region. In my next video, we'll deep dive into advanced tweaking of the CC1101 sub-gigahertz radio. So be sure to subscribe. Let's get started. So I thought I'd start by going to the flipper0.1 website. We'll click on docs. Then we'll click on sub-gigahertz. Then we'll scroll down to the sub-gigahertz hardware section. You can see the CC1101 and antenna operate at 300 to 348, 387 to 464. And 779 to 928 megahertz bands. The frequencies section lists which frequencies are available for each country. Here you can see the bands listed and the regions in which you're allowed to transmit on those bands. If you're not allowed to transmit, you'll see a transmission is blocked message on your Flipper Zero. On my Flipper, I'll go ahead and bring up sub-gigahertz, then I'll scroll down to region information. And you can see I'm in the US, and you can see the bands that are available to me. If I scroll back up to read, and then I'll go into config, and let's go into the beginning of these frequencies. You can see it started at frequency of 300, and it goes up to 925. If I scroll down to hopping and turn that on instead, you'll see the frequencies erased. There's no more list, and it's going to just bounce through a few of the common frequencies, which we can see here as it's scanning. So over in Visual Studio Code, I've pulled up the official firmware. I'm in the fruihalregion.c file. You can see it has various country codes, and then it has bands, how many bands are available, the start and end range of those bands, as well as the power limit and duty cycles. So this is how the Flipper Zero knows which regions and frequencies you're allowed to do transmissions on. Next, we'll look at the sub-gigahertz_setting.c file. This has all the frequencies that we're gonna do our read and read raw on, as well as our hopper frequencies. So here you can see in the Flipper Zero, as we flip through the frequencies, you can see how that correlates to the list of frequencies in this array. And then below that, you can see the hopper frequency list as well. Next, we have the setting_user.example file. And you'll see at the top line, this comment. Comments are with a pound sign at the beginning. It says to rename the .example file to just be _user. So we'll go ahead and say rename, and we'll remove this word example. And it looks like it doesn't allow me to just end with a dot, so also I'll remove the dot and save it. So the first thing we have is the file type, which is Flipper sub-gigahertz setting file. Next we have the file version, which is version 1. And then commented out is whether or not we want to add the standard frequencies and standard hopper frequencies. If you set this to true, it will add the standard frequencies from this list that we reviewed earlier. If you set it to false instead, then it will not add them and you'll have to manually add it. Don't forget to remove the comment to make this effective. So we'll uncomment some frequencies, so those will be added to our frequency list. If this was true, then they would be appended to the end of the list. So after the 900s, these 300 frequencies would show up. We'll go ahead and enable the default frequency, which is 433 megahertz, 0.92. I'm going to change that to 90 instead, so it's almost the same. And then we'll make frequencies that are all similar to that. We'll add 100 kilohertz per frequency. Gonna go ahead and just delete the comment since we don't need that. I'll go ahead and uncomment one of the hopper frequencies. If you set add standard frequencies to false, you must have a hopper frequency or else your settings file will get ignored. And then at the bottom of the file, I'm going to go ahead and add a custom preset. And we've named our custom preset AM_102, which has a narrow 102 kilohertz bandwidth and some hex data for the preset data. In my future video, I'll get into more details on what this data entails. Right click on Setting User and choose Reveal in File Explorer. Then we'll go into SD card, sub-gigahertz assets on the QFlipper app, and then we'll delete the setting user.example or setting user file that you may have. If you want, you can download it first, but in this case, I'm just going to go ahead and delete it. We'll confirm the delete, and then we'll drag the setting user file into that folder. We'll launch sub-gigahertz read, left arrow for config. Notice our frequency is the default frequency that we set on line 9. And as I press right arrow, you can see the other frequencies that are from lines 12 through 16. I'll do left arrow and you can see that these frequencies were appended to the end of the default frequency list. We'll start with 433.9. On my second flipper, I'll transmit on 433.92. And it got picked up. Next, we'll go into config and we'll change our frequency to 434. And again, it gets picked up. 434.1. And again, it gets picked up. 434.2. And again, it gets picked up. So now I want to switch modulation from AM650 over to AM_102, which was the new preset that we added on line 35 through 37, AM102. We'll switch our frequency back to 433.9. And then we're going to go ahead and broadcast on 433.92. We got the signal, so we'll go back to configure 434.0. And this time when we try to broadcast, you can see that it's not incrementing. We're still on signal 22 of 50. And the reason we're not getting the signal is because our custom preset was made for a 102 kilohertz bandwidth, which means you have to be within 50 kilohertz of the frequency. And we're currently 80 kilohertz above it. All right, so we've learned about how we can make our own modulations using custom preset name, module, and preset data. In the next video, I'll show you how to specify what that data is. We learned about how to add new frequencies to this frequency choice for reading a specific frequency that you care about. And we've learned that we can say true if we want all the existing frequencies and just put ours at the end, or we can say false if we just want to list all the frequencies that we want to be able to read. We learned that if we say false, we have to put the hopper frequency in here. We learned how to set our default frequency as well. One last thing I wanted to show was how to do some debugging. So we'll change our add standard frequencies to false. And then I will remove the hopper frequency. And then we'll change one of the frequencies to be out of range by removing a zero. We'll delete our old setting user file. And then we'll upload our updated setting user file into the Flipper. I'll bring up lab.flipper.net/CLI and type in log. And then on my Flipper, I'll launch the sub-gigahertz feature. So we can see in the log that the frequency was not supported. And then because we're missing the hopper frequency, we see the error loading user settings, loading default settings. When you're done with the logs, be sure to disconnect or else you'll get an error, cannot access serial port in the QFlipper app. So now you know how to use the setting user file to override the sub-gigahertz information. In my next video, we'll look at the custom preset data in detail. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe. If you have any questions, please leave them below.